back again with Annie, and Annie and I are going to talk to you about flirt poles. Flirt pole is basically a horse lunge whip or something like it, and you attach a toy to the end. In this case, I've got a wonderful tug toy that I got from a website called cleanrun.com, and it's neat because it's got a pocket and it's furry, and with the pocket you can put squeaky toys and treats in it and make it that much more fascinating for the dog. Just like this. You attach the toy to the end of the lunge pole, and okay, are you gonna sit? Annie wants to get going. She loves playing this. This is such a wonderful way to exercise your dog and get them self-control and focus. Hey, Annie, come. Good. Particularly in times when you might not be able to give them the exercise that you like to. What we're gonna do is start by playing a little bit of tug.
Get it, Annie.
You gonna get it? Yeah. Get it. Come on. Get it. Get it. Go, 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 go. Annie is wearing a biothane lunge or a spinning line right now. I like to use a 40-foot biothane line with her shell when we're outside of the fenced area. That way I can get her in the habit of paying attention to me when we're not in a fenced area. It's kind of like fishing. So that now I've got her interested in it. The next thing is I have to teach her to drop it as if she's never done it before. Drop. Good girl. She's never done it before. Hey, when you're teaching a dog to drop it, get them tugging and then drop their favorite treat, something that they can't resist, on the ground beside them. They'll spit out whatever is in their mouth and then you can say, good drop, and they will, they'll drop it and they'll start to get the idea that drop means spit it out. And then you can start to say drop and they'll spit it out and they'll think it's great. So the next thing you do is kind of go like this. You're going to tease the dog a little bit with the flirt pole. Get it, get it, get it, get it, get it, get it. And as you can see, Annie is getting quite a bit of exercise just by chasing after it. In her case, catching it. Okay, can you pull it, pull it, pull it? And pull is going to become the reinforcer for paying attention. Okay, drop, drop. Okay, and sit. The next thing I can do is tell Annie to sit. And if she gets up, I'm going to grab it, the toy, and I'll have the toy in my hand. And if she sits, I'm going to lower the toy down. And then I'm going to say, okay, go get it. Go get it. Go get it. Get it, get it, get it. You can get these things going around in circles around you, turning around, and not really great for on the camera, but it gives the dog masses of running exercise without you even going anywhere, and it's super fun. And you can teach them that they have to wait for things that they want, like chasing the toy. and they have to drop things in order to get to sit so that they can play another game. Anyway, that's just a fun way you can play with your dog, and I hope you find it useful, and we will see you next time.